Funding Month, presented with Oracle for Startups and American Express, recognizes the stories, lessons learned, and best practices shared by founders and funders around the world.
Namaste, Dr. Shyam Prasad Rajashagan, for this fireside chat of Startup Grind, where indeed it's a big pleasure to have you along with us.
Namaste, Rahulji. Thank you so much for having me on board Startup Grind Kanyakumari.
Thank you.
Being supported by Oracle for Startups.
Thank you. Funding Month presented with Oracle for Startups and American Express. Recognize the stories, lessons learned, and best practices shared by founders around the world. And this week, we have Dr. Shyam Prasad Rajashagan, the founder and the Chief Technology Officer of Wedgeroot AgriTech Private Limited. Wedgeroot AgriTech is one of the efficient supply chain platform. It's a growing efficient B2C supply chain platform by connecting farmers and consumers by employing technology and creating sustainable way for the growth of every stakeholder being part. There are about 1,500 customers, 5+ cities and towns, 110+ farmers and producers, 8+ women and transgenders employed, and 3+ passionate franchise holders and 15+ young enthusiasts associated with Wedgeroot. So, thank you, Shyam sir, for being one of our inspirations across, you know, entrepreneurs across this world. Before we formally start with the chat, let me ask us this one simple question. Why was this area you have chosen? There are multiple ways why you want to concentrate on this farming or agri-tech. Or maybe Wedgeroot is one kind of startup which uses extensive technology support for procuring farmers, connecting customers and with the farmers or customers or vice versa, whatever it is. And why this option?
Yeah, such a great question. In fact, I need to answer, because there are hundreds and hundreds of companies and startups and entrepreneurs who wish to do something on technology, who wish to take up, might be going through education initiatives, might be getting into SaaS-based platforms. But the point is, working on the ground is such a hectic task for many entrepreneurs out today. So I just wanted to create an impact in the society, connecting farmers and consumers in between, involving processes by applying technology. But the point is, I'm going to revolutionize the whole area of supply chain, which has not yet been into existence so far. And it's going to be challenging for me. And it was really a big task for me so far going through this supply chain platform, which made me to choose AgriTech, or might be agri-based supply chain is something like only thing which made me to choose is to connect farmers who are really in struggle during this lockdown, actually, might be during this pandemic. So they are not expecting for anything like getting a Lamborghini, or they are not expecting for anything. They just wanted to have food 3 times a day. So for that, they need someone to help them, actually. By eradicating the middlemen, we have been trying to do this. Soon we'll be in all the cities across India. Yes.
Dr. Shyam, you have been very engaged. There would have been a multiple career options for you, starting from a core company or within, entrepreneurs always have their own risk-taking. They need to take a couple of risks, but there was a safer side. On a personal note, there were a whole lot of safer side for you. Immediately completing the course, you would have worked for some corporates and you would have earned a handful of salary. Why entrepreneurship?
My biggest dream in life is not yet to be employed in any organization. That was my first biggest dream in my life, actually. Because getting employed in some organization and becoming an employee, which means that you will be restricting to something, you will be very much comfortable in with your earnings, what you get and things. But you cannot learn from the real world, which is very competitive today. But I always dream that every dream is possible. So I think which made me to choose entrepreneurship is something like, I was a backbencher, I don't study well. So this was the only option left to do a business from zero, from scratch, and I had to choose this option. And end point of the result was learning, failures, criticisms, going through the toughest task. What people wouldn't go through this at this moment of age, probably. I think 20 to 30 is the right age for people to start some business. This is the right time where you don't have responsibilities. You have lots of opportunities. People start noticing you. You have energy, you have passion, you have enthusiasm. You don't have so much of troubles, in fact, to run anything. So I think this is the right age for people. So that is why I started and I chose entrepreneurship. Yes.
So entrepreneurs might always have to face a couple of risks in their life to build their companies. So would you mind saying some of the risks which you took, you know, in building your company?
Definitely. Entrepreneurs are the one who's struggling hard every day, each and every moment, in fact. So if I'm talking with you now, I might be facing some issues on the ground, whereas my people would have been mistaking in delivery part or something else. So there might be issues going on. That is going to be challenging, in fact, at some point. But facing these challenges is totally different from the challenges what we faced in early stages of building a startup from scratch. So first point which I struggled very hard was something on building a startup from scratch, actually. So I didn't have money to build a startup. In fact, I had only 9 rupees in my hand. I went on to approach many schools to train kids on IoT. I started building a company in 2017 when I was in the age of 20, 21. So I went on to many schools to train kids on IoT. That moment of time, people were laughing at me, actually. See, this guy is going to train third and fourth grade children on IoT. Will this work out or things like that? It was something like I was very surprised, actually, because you're always training the kids with the theoretical methodologies, but I don't feel like theoretical methodologies will help the kids to grow beyond their life. That is the reason I went into schools, actually. So that was one challenge when I started I started taking up a deal from a school, and they weren't like interested to give up one deal to me, because it was just a startup. It was about a day or two old startup. So that is the phase where I faced many challenges. In fact, beyond that, I already have to go through many criticisms and failures in my startup journey, because of people who were surrounding me, were into many corporates doing big jobs. In fact, might be 60 or 70K a month, might satisfy them, but I don't get satisfied with those money or anything. I just wanted to follow my passion. So I came into this. When you follow your passion, you'll definitely be criticized. When you follow your dreams, you'll definitely be, pushed out of what you're doing, actually. This happens for every entrepreneur. These are two challenges which I faced. And probably beyond that, I have right set of people to connect. I have good platform like social medias to network and build my startup in a very bigger way. So I have possibilities of building. So everyone has possibility. There is not a code. Yes.
Definitely. Thank you. Thank you, sir, for that answer. And one thing, see, there are a lot of bitter experiences and seat experiences when you have to start with a company or when you are building your company. So what were those critical bitter experiences you faced when you were just starting the company, and how you converted this bitter experiences into the sweetest of experiences maybe later in the future?
Definitely, I have to tell this. In fact, I'll tell a small story in a very different way. So when I started VegRoot last year, it was about March or April in the last year. During the pandemic, it started. To connect farmers and consumers. In fact, in Coimbatore, I just started. It was about 9 p.m. in the night. And myself and my friend were discussing about this idea. And he told that we can start immediately. We don't wait for an opportunity. So waiting for an opportunity is like waiting for a boat in the desert. Right? And purchased a domain and started building a website, in fact. But I was not able to complete it within morning, actually. The very next day morning, I had to connect consumers initially. So I had to develop a kind of jot form kind of thing. And I started posting it saying, I'm going to deliver vegetables to your houses from farmers. If you are really interested, you can order with me. And I just posted to all my networks, and I took a small gap in between the day. And I was taking care of my works. In the evening, you don't believe, I got 22 orders actually for the very first day. So in the evening, I went on to many farmers. Went to meet them. I procured everything from them, and I came back to my home. And it took about two, 3 hours to segregate, pack, and then deliver it in the next day morning. So it was about 3,000 to 4,000 rupees in revenue for the first day. But first bitter experience what I had for the first day in my second startup journey, second startup was a customer ordered 140 kg of apple for 140 rupees. I went and delivered it to him. He was like, I'm not okay to take up this apple because it's not the best quality water. It's what I expected. I was something like, okay, let it be, not a problem. You can drop it, sir, not a problem. I'll bring you another kg of vegetable, another kg of apple. He was like, okay, get me another kg. Like, I got another kg of apple. I gave it to him. He was again not satisfied. I again took 140 rupees, went to a supermarket. I again got 180 rupees worth apple, actually. It was a different apple. So he was happy with that. But I sacrificed everything, like respect. He didn't respect me. He didn't respect my feelings. He didn't respect a person. But end point is my customer. I have to take care of everything. I have to take care of my customer. So that was a very bitter experience. And end point, when I gave it to him, I was very satisfied. And today, I have close to 200 customers from that one single gated community. So one bitter experience, which converted into a sweeter experience at some point, within half an hour of time, I sacrificed 300 rupees. I now make 35,000 a month. Yes.
Wow. That was a superb conversion of bitter experience into a sweet experience. Let this be a message to all and budding entrepreneurs out there. My next question focuses on building any companies, coming back to our funding month. Building any company definitely requires investments. So what was your first investment apart from in terms of money? Who was the first one to fund you for your dream?
My fund was completely the innovation and creativity when I started building my startup. In fact, that is the frank opinion which I wanted to tell you, actually. Just because when you wanted to start doing something, then people will definitely appreciate you, but they don't believe you knew whether it will be in a consistent way. That is how it happens for every startup, I think so. So obviously you have to invest your innovative thought process and creativity to begin a startup. When you start doing a startup and when you start, delivering it to your customers, initial investments will be somewhere around for the core objectives, not for the comfortable things which you have to invest actually. You have to invest for the core requirements, such as, the materials or the objects which requires to connect people. So that is what is required as initial funding, actually. So myself and my friend together started. He was very interested to invest somewhere around 20,000 rupees for the startup. It was just a weighing scale, couple of tarpaulins, and a week of cost which has to be involved for the vegetable broker. That was the first investment initially, I swear. And probably when I started building it, it was really good. It was really pleasant. And at some point, we had to develop ourselves to pitch into different cities, giving franchises for over 5 cities across different destinations like Chennai, Bangalore, Goa, even Pollachi and other areas. And through that, we started raising revenue. And through that, we started showcasing it to people. At some point, you don't believe. End point, what happened was, we have been approached by a company. They have promised giving us $1 million funding within a couple of weeks' time. So we have been getting closely 6.7 crores of funding very soon, another couple of weeks. So raising this fund, it took approximately around 1 year of time for me to attain first round of grant or the funding, which is refundable funding. And it is an ROI based funding actually, but people have been inspired by the idea and they are ready to invest on the idea. But the point is, it's not just because of the investment you have to agree and take up the investments. It's about how the investor is seeking you, how the investor is approaching you, how kind is the investor to you. And it's not about the funds, it's not about the grant, it's not about anything. It's always about the networking and the connect between you and the investor. These two are major points. For expansion of business, investments is the much needed factor for expansion of your business from A to the B segment. Because now we are doing it in a small scale. If we wanted to do it in a big scale, if you have big dreams, obviously you have to get in investments or venture capitalist funding, or might be grant, or might be seed funding, or anything it might be. So don't think about failures, or don't think about if you're going to face any negatives in terms of after investments or anything. Everything happens for some reason, and probably vitamin M is the most important factor of building or expanding the business from one place to another in a very large scale. So it took another 9-10 months of time to build revenue, another 3 months of extra time to get in, rope in investments in larger scale for first round of funding. Yeah, so they were inspired by the idea. They are investing on this idea. So obviously, when you start doing a business, start building revenue, showcase it to people. When people being inspired by your idea, they'll definitely invest on you. That's not going to be a task.
And coming back to about technology, so Startup Grant, we as a Startup Grant, as a community, we always support tech founders. But you know, this business, agri business. Much people have exploited the use of technology in agricultural field probably for some years by now. And what inspired you to go with the technology enabled platform in terms of farming or in terms of agriculture or whatever we say? What inspired you to use technology into it?
To solve the major problem which society or farmers or might be stakeholders who are being part of your organization is facing. It can be only done through technology, by involvement and employment of technology. It cannot be done without technology, because technology is growing far today. But point is, like, where we stand and what we do is the most important factors of building a successful business in the right way. So what made me to, you know, invest on technology, or what made me to employ technology, something like I had developed India's first chatbot for farmers, actually. Which made me to develop was something like, I had an idea. We are using Alexa, we are using many, many bots, in fact, on everyday basis. We use Siri, we use Play, and everything we use, actually. But point is, like, farmers are the one, other stakeholders who have been part of us are not using these kind of chatbots. I thought, like, why don't we give kind of chatbots to them to sell the vegetables to us and in an easier way, so that they'll be getting in touch with us as soon as possible without calling this, or might be getting into a mobile application to download the application or do anything, actually. And that made me to think, in fact, if every technology should be available for everyone in easier way as much as possible. That is the secret of implementing or employing technology in the right way, I think. So it is not like only educated people should be using technology. It should be like everyone can use technology, but it should be simplified as much as possible for the person who used that. That is the most important factor which made me to inspire to apply technology in the right way. And you don't believe, uneducated farmer who's from the Western Ghats of our city is using AI-based chatbot to deliver the vegetables to us. We are using the procurement methodology to connect farmers through AI-based chatbot, which has been developed by us. Yes.
So, which means you are taking technology to every nook and corner of the city.
Yes,
so, with this focus, my next question comes to your, in terms of you as a startup founder, you have definitely inspired a whole lot of people out there in terms of bringing, like, you know, micro outlets, which is definitely a revolution of ours. So, could you share some insights about the micro outlets, micro green outlets?
Definitely.
And plus, there is one another thing which have captivated a lot of people, the vast employee of the LGBT community, lot of transgenders has been uniquely appointed at Vegroot. People are usually say inclusion, diversity, but you made that inclusion, diversity, everything into practice. So covering these two points, what made you?
Definitely. It's a challenging question for me, but still I'll try to answer it in the right way. So first point, getting into microgreen stores was something like, microgreens are the microgreens and greens as well, both together, spinach or might be coriander or might be things. So what I did was, like, many people were investing on the shops, taking a retail shop for over 4 or 5 lakhs in revenue. 4 or 5 lakhs investing on the advance for the next 10 months, and probably they'll be spending at least 20,000 to 30,000 rupees a month as rent for the shops, actually. From the revenue what they make each and every day, they can't even afford the rent each and every month. That cannot be possible through the small scale business which is happening today. It can be possible for large scale companies, like many companies are doing that in a large scale, like supermarkets and hypermarkets can afford for the rent and can afford for the interiors or anything. So seeing all these points, I was also noticing many, many streets, roadside vendors who have been selling greens each and every day morning in all the cities across India, in all the destinations across India. So I thought, like, why don't we create a kind of a stall or a kind of a kiosk which might benefit everyone, which might bring new gen entrepreneurs to sell greens and microgreens from the stores. You don't believe, if I'm going to sell a kind of a cut of a bunch of spinach, I'll be selling it for 12 rupees. And if I'm going to chop the spinach and if I'm going to pack it up in a cover and I'm going to sell, it costs somewhere around 30 rupees a month, 30 rupees a bunch actually. You don't believe. So innovation resides there actually. And probably I can sell up to, I can make a sale for at least 2,000 to 3,000 rupees in revenue every day. So my profit is around 700 to 800 rupees for a day actually. My expenditure for the whole shop is somewhere around 6,000 rupees. It's a one-time cost. I don't need to reinvest on the shop. I don't need to pay rent for the shop. Early in the morning, 2 hours. Again, in the evening, 2 hours. A person can be self-employed. A person can earn 1,000 rupees a day from this shop alone. So they have to invest 6,000 rupees as for taking up one shop and can sell to 200 customers a day. That can be possible, actually. This is very much easily possible. So if they're taking up 20 different shops, 20 different microgreen stores, I'll be giving everything. You take care. You only target customers. You only sell the producers and greens to the customers. That's more than enough. This was my model. And I went to many gator communities. They all approached. They all accepted. So it is a very good model. In fact, I don't need to invest on the shops. I don't need to invest on rent or anything. It's a pack and, you can open the shop in the morning. You can go with the bag, open the shop, make a stall, keep all the vegetables or the greens, whatever you wanted to sell. You sell it. You make it all through UPI. You again pack it up and take a bag, hold it on your shoulder, get back to your work. Again, in the evening, when you come back from your work, refresh yourself, go open the bags, take a kiosk, set up, sell 600 to 700 rupees, earn 300 rupees of profit, again, go back home. You can earn 700 to 800 rupees easily in a day, actually, if you're really passionate and interested. First point. Second point, bringing in right set of people, like everyone are humans in this world. People, it depends on people. It depends on their individual. It is not mandate, to a person to be on the same gender. It is not mandate to a person to be on the same gender. It cannot be framed by anyone else actually in this world. So it depends on their own freedom. It depends on their own field of work. It depends on their own mindset actually. But people in this competitive world, what they think is like men and women are the only people who reside in this world, and so-called transgenders or might be from or any other communities or any other people are not part of this world. They think like that actually. I just wanted to break that. And in fact, by giving them an opportunity who had not yet been getting into even school education is now being the city's, operations head in Coimbatore actually. She's so-called Raisa. I feel very proud about her actually. She has just completed her 7th or 8th standard in fact. She's about 20 years old right now. She's very bold. She's energetic. She's enthusiastic. She's passionate. What needs more than that? Let her be a transgender. What needs more than that? She's very passionate. She's interested. That's enough to bring in the right people. And I believe in that. It's not like she's skilled actually. She's the right person to be employed with us. I think like everyone should get an opportunity. Everyone should be employed, whoever is unemployed. And they have enough dreams to be achieved. And they are the right persons to be employed. And many people criticize me saying like they are not going to be the right person to handle your customers. And you don't believe, end point, they were trained by the most superior vice chancellor of an university in India. He trained them directly. He trained all the transgenders directly. And he was very much happy to train all the transgenders to handle customers in terms of communication, in terms of behavioral and everything. So soon I'll be employing 200 transgenders in India. So, yes.
Wow. So before going to next questions, let's give a whole round of applause to Shyamji. One more time, everyone. So the virtual applause to you. And coming back to our topic, which we have planned for today, and we are speaking about ecosystem, funding, all mechanisms, and my question was completely redundant. Now, very close, let me ask this question. How much do you feel that now agri-tech industries can raise funds that can help them scale to a very large extent?
Yes, there is a huge possibility of each and every agri-tech startup or might be agro-tech or you know, any kind of agritech or agrotechs or any kind of startups related to agriculture can raise millions and millions of funding actually. But point is, where we stand, what we do and how we do are three different perspectives which we have to focus initially to get a grant or the funding, or might be investments or seed funding or venture capitalist funding, whatever it may be. So you have to understand the real time problems which is being faced by people, and you have to try solving it, what other companies haven't done so far, what other entities haven't done so far. That is where startup ecosystem stands, and that is where you can show yourself in a unique way. And probably by having different sets of ideologies, different sets of products, different set of thought process, in fact, and by engaging, by employing technology, you can attain the grant or the funding in the right and the easy way, as much as possible. Second point, when you showcase your revenue, when you showcase your model, it should inspire people. By inspiring people, definitely they'll be a good supporter for your initiative. These are a couple of perspectives. Third perspective might be, whenever you start doing something, you should feel like doing it in a large scale. Actually, where if you don't have money, also try doing it in a large scale. Might be without any comfortable things, you can do anything in a large scale. You can do it actually. If I have funding, then probably I'll be employing a couple of people to one thing, and I'll be asking them to deliver. But if I wanted to learn something, I have to be employed with it. I have to learn from the things which I have been into a process or might be into learning. So that is the most important factor for bringing in fundings or investments for a company. So these are three, four perspectives which I basically focus. And as an agri-tech entity, I think like there is a huge hollow space left in between to connect the right set of stakeholders into your organization. You also have good opportunity to connect many, many, many segments of people to have the right, right vision, who have right passion to drive your dreams and vision to the next level. So I think like there is a huge opportunity for everyone. Everyone can come into agri-tech space. There is a huge need for this, in fact. Yes.
So my next question goes with your experience and with your expertise. What must be the three ground rules to raise funds? Probably a couple of ground rules, probably three ground rules that can help you to raise funds.
Definitely. First perspective which I wanted to tell you people is networking. That is the first important factor, I think, like anything to raise funds or to attract your investors, to attract people. You have to be a good networker. Actually, that is the most important perspective which I had usually followed actually, and the person who was inspired by the idea and the person who wanted to invest on this idea were seeking me for more than 9 or 10 months of time before I started doing this stuff. And it was about 1 year down the line. It was about it is maximum of 9 to 10 months down the line before initiating the startup. I told him that I'm going to start. He was like, okay, you're the good marketer, you are the good networker, so I think like you'll be the right person where I could invest my funds. And that is the first perspective goes for networking. Second thing, you have right set of people with you, right set of ideas with you, right set of problem statements and right set of solutions for the problem statements which is not yet been solved or defined by any other entity so far. They might have been solved. You focus on three different things as being an agri-tech co-founder. I'm just telling you three things. One is time, second is quality, third is pricing. Don't compromise in these three things. If you're not going to compromise in these three things, definitely people will be approaching you for anything and everything. These are the three successful and secret factors of running a startup in a successful way. First is never sacrifice on your quality. Second thing is never sacrifice on pricing. Just keep the best pricing away from other competitors. Third point, never ever go beyond time. Just pursue on time. These are three major perspectives. These are three secrets of my success in terms of attaining a funding. Third point, first is networking. Second is this. And third point, I would like to let you know is one thing. Showing your expansion or growing beyond limits is something like, don't think about fear of failures. Go attain the right people. Go work on the ground. Think about the negatives and positives which is being present in front of you. Attain all the possibilities. Let it come let it all go, not a problem. You are going to have the right life, you have time to do. So I think like not only investments will make you grow, but not only without investments also you can't grow. So you are stuck in between. So you need investments, you need source of vitamin M to grow beyond greater heights. For attaining vitamin M, it is so-called the biggest supplement for your success. But initially you showcase your model, you come up with the right revenue model, people will definitely invest in it. So these are three perspectives which I usually follow and I wanted to follow every day. Yes.
Wow. So my next question turns up something which is very critical. Number one is, what is the short-term goal of Vegroot Agritech Private Limited? And next is, what is the long-term goal of Vegroot Agritech Private Limited?
Okay. Short-term goal of Vegroot Agritech was something like last year. I just wanted to start because I got exited as founder from a different organization. I started, I just wanted to deliver it to 50, 60 customers a day. That's it. That was my initial goal actually. And someone inspired me to connect with many cities and there stopped my second milestone. Whereas I had been struggling very hard to deliver the right quality at right pricing actually. But still I'm doing it in the right way. So these were a few short-term goals, in fact, but on a longer run, I have long-term goals in terms of, I usually compete with long-term goals, actually. I might not have good funding today. I might not have good space to operate today. I might not have a good set of people to connect with me today. But I think I have good visionary people for next 20, 30 years down the line. I wanted to expand this to at least 300 cities across India. I wanted this to operate not only in metros or non-metros, but it has to operate in towns, even like, in small towns, even like Pollachi, kind of towns like Pollachi, Kangayam, and small towns across different destinations, actually. People there also wanted to be engaging with technology. They wanted the right quality, right pricing, right veggies, and at right time, actually. So I think there is a huge hollow space in between. So I started connecting many small towns, like even Pollachi. I went on for the field inspection. I had see the real outcome from what people are expecting there from towns like Pollachi and Nagarkoil and other aspects actually. So my longer term vision is to bring in 200, for the next 2 years, I have two goals actually. One is to expand this business to at least 300 destinations, to create 100 entrepreneurs who wants to build a new business. And also to bring in transgenders and women who are unemployed. We have to make them employed. We have to make them skilled. We have to give them a self-employment opportunity. And third point, I have to make this as a bigger supply chain platform to connect farmers and consumers in the right way, and to improvise my technology as much as possible.
Sir, in terms of impact, all business has its own impact. So you are in a very core sector, especially in a state like Tamil Nadu or especially South India. Farming or farming related technologies must make a big impact for sure. So in that terms, how much impact have Vegroot have done for farmers or the end customers or your stakeholders?
For the farmer community, see, my stakeholders are from five different areas actually. One is the farmer community where we procure vegetables, in fact. Second is the people who have been employed with us probably, and on full time based on technology, supply chain, logistics, and other aspects. Third point is like we create opportunities for people, in fact, who wants to build a new business can start working with us probably. And at some point of time, they'll be given an opportunity to start a new business. And final point might be, we are also connecting, supply chain platforms to connect, the consumers from different areas and different segments of customers. It's not only like people who have affordability to buy vegetables from hypermarket can get from us. It's all about people who get in the market can also afford from us, actually. This is what I wanted to frame, actually. And these are major stakeholders who have been part of Vegroot, in fact. So the impact what I create or what I make between people is something like, I make them to buy in the consistent, way to connect, the right set of consumers. And I also impact farmers because I don't want to bargain from them for the vegetables what I procure. So it's all about if they are able to sell it for 10 rupees, I'll get it for 11 rupees actually. That is how I can impact farmer communities today. And I'm making their work simple by giving them everything, including the seeds and fertilizers very soon. I'll be making them to be to be skilled enough to run this in a very different perspective. So I am impacting all the stakeholders being part of Vegroot. In fact, for the pharma communities, I'm getting it at the right pricing, additional pricing at least. So I'm helping consumers, every consumers to get it from us at the right pricing. Also, the stakeholders have been a part of us who wants to build a new business can approach us, can start running a business with us. They also can be self-employed. Fourth point, they have people who are something like transgenders and women are unemployed. They have been a stakeholder. They are also getting benefited. End point, everyone in the organization are getting better. So that is what I feel like this world is going to be a better place to live.
Wow. The next question, in the sense, is a pre-final question to be very open. So to raise funds or to get funds for a long-term run, what is more important as per your business idea innovation, process innovation, or technology innovation?
So put together to attain funding for the next 5-10 years down the line, it goes on a series of funding actually. So to attain first or second round of funding, obviously your brand needs to be, you know, familiarized with people. Your brand needs to be impactful to the people who approaches your brand. Second point might be your business strategy, your way of doing your business, your way of impacting in the social way, and all should be very, you know, very precise in terms of attaining the goal, attaining the funding. Next might be technology, which plays a major role in terms of attaining the funding for the first or second round. Actually, might be next initiative might be the thought process of business, thought process of upscaling your solution for the problem statement which you have identified. You have to keep on solving a problem every day. You have to keep on facing challenges. By facing challenges, you keep on updating yourself. By updating yourself, you get to learn so many things. By learning so many things, you will be able to expand your initiative to higher levels actually, whereas you can approach and attain funding in the right way. So these are all few aspects for attaining fundings in for longer term. It's not only for attaining a funding, it's not only business plan or business report or pitch desk is required. I didn't have any pitch desk so far. I just had a couple of sheets which contains an Excel sheet including ROI and one sheet which includes the investments and expansion of business, what would be the ROI in years. That's it. These were two terms. And only thing which impacted the investor was the idea, problem statement, which is being solved in a different way by applying technology and social way by connecting right set of people as your stakeholders. For now. Yes.
Wow. So with my last question, this is in fact not a question. As a founder, us SPR, we call it with love, we call him as SPR, Shyam Prasad Rajshekar. So that's what it is. So with as an founder like SPR, as Vegroot Agritech, what is your message to the young startup founders or budding entrepreneurs?
Definitely, I don't have much age to advise you people, but I have good learnings to tell you people that what I've come across. So definitely work hard, work smart, work on the ground, understand the real life adventures, come across many failures. Don't think about you're going to fail. Be very happy when you fail and be neutral when you succeed. And when you are very happy when you fail, it's something like the high time for you to grow beyond greater heights. And probably work on the ground. It's the most important factor of building a business in the right way. Network with the right segment of people, use social media in the right way. You have good platforms to showcase your idea. You have good platforms to let people know that what you're actually doing. Don't be restricted to you yourself towards social media. If you are keen on something, then it's not something like if you're going to show your face, it's not something like no one is going to offend you or do anything. So come out of the student life, what you have come across so far, and get into a professional life. Whereas you get into a professional life, it's always like, you have to be very keen in terms of showcasing yourself to the society, understanding what society needs today, what society expects from you today, and what is that you have impacted, how is that you have impacted society in the right way. So be open to people, be open to ideas, be open to lots and lots of strategies, be open to failures, be open to challenges, be open to success. Work on the ground. You are this startup journey is yours. This startup initiative is yours. And also give equal opportunity for people who need it. These are a few important factors which I want to tell you. And don't be very comfortable with the fundings, whichever you approach or get or people invest on your startup. Just invest on expanding your business. Save it for another 2-3 years down the line. You go work on the ground. Make it a sustainable venture. Give all the investments whichever you have attained and make yourself a successful entrepreneur.
Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Startup Brand Kanyakumari, Funding Month presented at Oracle for Startups and American Express. Recognize the stories, lessons learned, and best practices shared by founders and funders across the world. We have an ethics which we follow in Startup Brand. One thing is that how SPR and how Vegroot Agritech can be of help to the startup ecosystem of the world. How can you help the startup ecosystem?
We'll be able to mentor young age startups who has passion, who wants to have a platform to exhibit their ideas. We'll definitely guide them. We'll definitely help them out in terms of building it in the right way and a better way. And next point might be I can mentor. We'll be a good mentor to the startups who wants to build the organization in a very bigger way. Don't have any restrictions like 9-to-5. Job what people are going through right now. So you wanted to work very hard. If you're going to work hard, you are the right person to have me as your mentor. Next thing, you have to work smart. For working smart, I'll give you some ideas and inputs on building your startup into a very bigger scale as much as possible. And as much as possible, definitely in any way, whatever the supports can be done from my end will definitely be done at any cost. There is no doubt.
Thank you, Spear. And before we go to the next part, let us take some Q&A. So participants, if you have any questions, you're very free, open to drop it in chat box, or you could unmute yourself and definitely could ask. So probably hope all the questions you have can be asked with free of mind. This is a very casual chat, and Startup Brand as an ecosystem developers, we always contribute to the positive development of startup founders and also the budding entrepreneurs across the world. So please feel free to ask your questions, any of your questions you do have, whether you are from an academia, whether you're from industry, or whether you're from any part of the world, it doesn't matter. Any questions that you can have, unmute yourself and you can ask. Abrahami, you have some questions that you have wanted to ask with Shyamji?
Sir, actually I was listening to his speech and then I find inspiring that is the factors like time, quality and price never compromise with that. So I need something like that.
You need some other secrets like that actually?
Yes, sir.
So behind all those three factors, there are lots of secrets involved. Compromising the quality, time and pricing, these are first major important factors of running a business sustainably initially. And to make it grow big, your product has to be more efficient. More efficient in the sense it should be easily usable to people, easy to use by people who have been your stakeholders. And you have to build social values for organization. That is the most important factor. When you create your startup, it's not something like you have to employ only educated people. It's all about you can also employ uneducated. You can make them skilled. And you don't believe more than educated people, unemployed and uneducated can do wonders actually. And you also have to employ them. By employing them, you'll have great sets of insights from those people, because they all could have worked on the ground, they all could have noted the possibilities, and they'll be giving you lots and lots of insights. So because I had an experience of employing and engaging sorts of people, actually that's what I'm sharing with you. That is again a secret. I don't believe in certificates or percentage or marks or anything, theoretical education or anything. I just believe in practical learning. So I think like whomever has passion can start driving the vehicle with you, so-called the startup vehicle with you. When it stops, you both have to get down, you both have to repair your car. Again, you both have to get into the vehicle. If it again stops, take a person who is very much skilled to repair the vehicle in the right way so that the repair doesn't alone happen the next time. So when again, if it goes on to a trouble, again, hire one more person who can drive the vehicle in the right way that what you are not able to drive, so that the vehicle doesn't stop at any point, having kind of any repairs of the speeding or might be due to, the system errors or anything which happens. So this is how you can have the right set of people on your board as team members. Having right set of team members is the most important factor of building any business in a successful way and a sustainable way as well. And beyond that, pricing quality, these are the three important factors. Once again, I wanted to say, don't compromise in these three things and sacrifice your sleep. That will build your startup into a next level. And enjoy your work, whatever. That is the most secret of success.
Thank you so much, Abrahami. Hope it answered the question. Of course, Abrahami, Startup Brand will definitely be a support and help for you in terms of your progressive development as well. You can keep our word. So I think there are no other questions from the attendees. We have one other question. Aditya have just joined. Okay. So, Shyam sir, we have a tradition of asking this question at Startup Grant. How can we help? As Startup Grant, how can we be a helper? How can we help?
In any kind of supports, any kind of contribution from Startup Grind is most welcome. Actually, I don't have any kind of particular thing to ask you, because you Startup Grind is into a very larger scale, who's doing wonders. I have been going through many updates for the past recent years. In fact, when I came to know about Startup Grind and the contribution you make to society, to this entrepreneurs, is something, it's not countable actually. Cannot be countable, in fact. So I think like any kind of contributions, any kind of supports from your end are most welcome. We'll be happy to attain anything, and we'll be definitely promising that we won't miss it at any point of time, having your trust with us.
Thank you so much. A Startup Grind, as you said, it's the world's largest community of entrepreneurs. And we, on a personal note, I wish that Pedroot AgriTech let it expand across the world. Each part of the world, let Vegroot AgriTech may mark its food. That's what we wish. Lakshmi Narayanan sir has a chat. It is an interactive session with Dr. Shambhu's innovative model of business. Very good. Thank you, Lakshmi Narayanan sir. So it's an appreciation to you. The business model.
Thank you, sir.
Lakshmi Narayanan sir, you can unmute yourself and you could introduce yourself to Shyam sir as well. Actually, Lakshmi Narayan sir is a professor from VIT University.
Very nice, sir. Very nice. You're not
audible. Naga Missions. Lakshmi Narayan sir, you're not audible, sir. Yeah, Arubade VIT Institute of Technology, AVIT Chennai.
Very nice. Very nice.
Sir, you're not audible, sir. Probably there wasn't, yes, sir, issues with mic. No problem, sir. Thank you, sir. So definitely the questions, the one thing goes to everyone, how Startup Grind can be a help for all of you. At this point of time, I would like to, there is other, someone very specific, someone specific want to meet you at this point of time. Namaste, Gautam Ji, Gautam Palaniswami. Unmute yourself and we can say hi to Shyam Prasad Ji.
Hi.
Hello,
hi, sir.
Gautam. Very much happy. Hi, Gautam. How are you? Sorry.
Hi. Thank you. Happy to meet in this platform. First of all, Rahul sir, apologies.
I am very much inspired by all your works. In fact, your way of supporting student communities today. So I have to thank on behalf of Rahul sir and all the team members being present here. So I feel very blessed that we have been associated for very long time. Yes.
Yes, in this platform, I should really mention one or two things. Like, first thing is, in mentor things, in the first stage of support things, at the very early stage, the first person whom I approached is obviously Shams. So with him only, I have started all these things. By the boost up he gave in the past, in the first lockdown, still we are, so such kind of boost up, that was impacted me in a large kind of thing. Even last month, in somewhat, I was in a bit of depression and I texted him. Thank God he didn't even put me a reply. That even boosted me a lot. So that resulted in there is kind of works, you know. Okay, people are trusting you, just push hard, push hard. And today it's really, it's working out well. So the things Shyamanna is doing, I'm just following. So he's one kind of mentor for me now. And Abhirami is one of the result out of it. I am so happy she is also in this platform.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes, and brother. Thanks, Rahul, sir.
You are my guest for the next month as well. I'm hosting you as well because it is one of the most powerful incubators. Startup Grint takes incubators, innovators, all into account and as an ecosystem partners. So you are one of the you are from one of the powerful incubators of the state. So definitely, a month line next month, you will be also a guest speaker part of Startup Grind.
We'll be so pleased for that. Thank you, and for sure we will come with a better support package. Exclusively for Startup Grid.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. And Shyam, sir, so this funding month is supported by Oracle for Startups and American Express. And they, as a token of love, as a token of appreciation, we, a Startup Grid, would like to honor you with a kind of gift from our global sponsors. Oracle for Startups, and by the time I think it has reached you, at the same time, we'll be happy that we'll share it as well on the screen.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Hope it has reached you. It has been from Oracle for Startups, and American Express is honoring you with this a small token of appreciation. And we have one more token of appreciation from our local partner, FinOS. FinOS is a digital banking inclusions company. The first and best startup in Kanyakumari district, and they want to honor you with a small token of appreciation. And
thank you so much, everyone. Oh wow, it's very nice actually. Thank you so much. It's so
startup, and not only this, and there are a couple of gifts as well. Which will be mailed to you in a very short span of time. Not mailed, I mean, it will be courier to you in a very short span of time.
It's very nice, actually. Those are very cute gifts. Thank you so much.
There are some partner gifts which you can avail exclusively for you supporting our startups. Oracle for Startups and American Express is fondly supporting all the startup partners, especially technology startups. So there are not only them, we have enclosed a couple of other partner benefits as well. But exclusively funding month is sponsored by Oracle for Startups and American Express Corporate Program for Startups. So we request you to make use of all these opportunities. And also, thank you for being a so inspirational support to the startup ecosystem of this country. On a closing note, the Veg Route AgriTech progressed as a company. Shyam Prasad as a founder is just amazing. We want to give a big salute to you for being such an aspiring innovative businessman, innovative founder, for making the whole ecosystem proud of.
Thank you,
definitely for sure. Thank you so much for joining us. So we are stopping the a big thanks to all the participants who have joined for this fireside chat. It's almost time to call it as a day. The funding month of Startup Grind is presented with Oracle for Startups and American Express, where we recognize the stories of founders, investors, and funders from across the world. Startup Grind is basically giving you a lot of lessons, entrepreneurship teaching, or much more. Be part of Startup Grind. Be part of our local ecosystem. Be part of our chapter as well to avail to know more about entrepreneurship. And let us know how we can help you in any sense. Once again, thank you so much, all of you, for joining us. And a special thanks once again, Shyam sir, for accepting the invitation of Startup Grind, having a delivering session on funding. Thank you so much, and big thanks.
Thank you so much, sir, Startup Grind Kanyakumari, especially to Rahul sir and team for organizing this funding month, and probably it's such a great honor to have every great inspirations on board with us today. So I hope that I am a small stakeholder in society, but the things which you people are doing is such a great initiative. So keep on growing, keep on inspiring us with all the possibilities. Thank you so much, everyone. All the very best, and please kindly take care and stay safe.
And a special thanks to our local partner FinOS Technologies as well for supporting this program. Thank you, Arun Rajiv Shankaran sir, founder and CEO of FinOS Technologies, for supporting this program. Once again, thank you so much, everyone, for joining us this day. It's bye bye from Startup Grind Kanyakumari chapter, Funding Month presented Oracle for Startups and American Express.
Funding Month, presented with Oracle for Startups and American Express, recognizes the stories, lessons learned, and best practices shared by founders and funders around the world.